The TZ16 Actian was one of the first SnowRunner Phase 1 DLC trucks. Here's my verdict, including details of its customization, off-roadability, and what makes it special. Until there's a uni mod added to SnowRunner, the TZ16 Actian is the closest thing we have. And that's okay because this gathering of Russian metal and rubber is one of the most versatile small trucks, surpassing even the International Loadstar 1700. The TZ16 Actian is named after a young hunter who accidentally stumbled upon a god bathing naked, and she got embarrassed, so turned him into a stag. He was then pursued and eaten by his own dogs. Imagine explaining that to an insurer. Anyway, there are no naked babes here, but there's definitely a hunter vibe. It has, for example, switchable all-wheel drive, switchable diff lock, and raised suspension, so it's well equipped to survive in the wilderness. And unlike the original roster of scout trucks, it can carry one slot of cargo in the small flatboard bed, so it's able to carry its prey home, regardless of the terrain. It can even do so while equipped with a crane and spare wheel, which can be handy. Wait a second, the TZ16 is an off-road truck, isn't it? Well, yes, however, unlike all other non-scout trucks, it can fit an autonomous winch. A medium-sized one, in fact, suggesting maybe one day there will be an even bigger truck with this ability. Should you prefer to carry fuel around, you can equip the unique-looking small fuel carrier, which holds 270 liters of the stuff. Or go for the maintenance frame add-on and slap on the roof rack to make it a mobile repair beast. Like a hunter, it can strike quickly too, thanks to the high-range gearbox option, as well as the off-road one, in case you need a little more traction in bad conditions or have something heavy to tow. ATMS1 mud tires are the star of this show because these are a variant of the balloons you get on the Taiga 6436 and soon to be the ANK MK38. Go watch that video. They are almost as large too, at 47 inches. Fit these and not only do you get better stability and off-road performance, you also get the closest thing to a baby monster truck. The SnowRunner developer's fascination with Greek mythology continues among the aesthetic upgrades, as one of them is known as the Hunter Front Bumper, which gives the TZ16 Actian a military vibe. Speaking of which, 5 variants of camouflage can be applied in addition to the usual paint color options. Just so you know, the TZ16 is on screen right now. In terms of performance, this particular TZ is more the hunter than the hunted. It's an all-round beast that can scout just about anywhere and even act as a mini cargo hauler, a baby Taiga in a manner of sorts. Except like the Actian character in the story, the TZ16 has its moments where it gets eaten by dogs. Fit some of the chunkier add-ons, for instance, and boy does it like falling over, especially with the raised suspension option. You can counteract this somewhat by taking the active suspension alternative, which can raise and lower the TZ16 whenever you want, but it can't bounce like those American lowriders. However, this limits you to smaller tires, which means weaker off-road performance and a slower speed. On the flip side, the TZ and its nippiest engine, the IMZ6210, can be a handful, so it's not always the worst idea to lose some speed. Although the middle engine option is too weak to be enjoyable, so avoid that. Is it worth using the TZ16 over a bigger truck? In some instances, yes. The ability to carry cargo and write itself can be useful, such as for the Amandra garage mission. And the Russian Unimog wannabe can manage a crane, sideboard bed, and a trailer at the same time, for a total of 5 cargo slots. But then its smaller dimensions make it more likely to tip than, say, a Taiga or Veyron, and it can be a twitchy beast to steer when using those Taiga tires. In fact, it's dismal on tarmac compared with the off-road tires, however these are thin and worsen its stability. And with 110 litre fuel capacity before the roof add-on, that up to 11 litre a minute thirst makes long deliveries of longer items challenging, or terrifying, whichever you prefer. Honestly, for a single piece of cargo and particularly difficult deliveries where you may need to recover, the TZ16 can be great. It's also good for scouting hard-to-reach areas and can be fun once you get used to its quirks. However, compared with something a little larger, the twitchy handling, speed, and stability trade-offs are too much the rest of the time. I can see why that god turned him into a stag after all. And that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to subscribe, like, and check out my merchandise. All support is greatly appreciated. Take care, bye.